Poulter. My company's called Patty Cake Patty Cake, and I started it 15 years ago. There are all sorts of different types and styles of wedding cakes. Stacked cakes, which originally came from America. Individual cakes are still incredibly popular, everything from small ice cakes to cupcakes to individual mousses or even donuts. Brides are more discerning than they were 10 years ago. Often I think that stems now because the couple are actually paying for the wedding themselves, and they then feel if they're buying the cake and it's not being given by a mother or a grandmother or something, then they want to buy what they want. Here's a selection of some of my wedding cakes. They're all different, they're all completely individual. The cake over here was designed to match the bride's wedding dress. The flowers were on the bodice, and then on the neck skirt there were little pearl beads, so we mirrored that in the cake. Iced the cake in ivory, the pearl beads are in white so they stand out, and the flowers are done with a technique which is called brush embroidery, where you pipe the icing onto the cake and then use a paintbrush to drag it through, so you've got an embroidered textured feel to the icing rather than it being straight icing. Often you do actually go through quite an intricate planning stage. A bride might come to you with one idea, and then once you've done a sketch she gets a different idea from that. So ideally sort of 2 to 3 months gives you a nice time not to get too bored with the whole thing, and to have enough time to plan it so it's not a big rush at the end when you want to be worrying about other things than your cake. This cake I call my 1960s sort of pop art, rather fun cake. It's got these big funky flowers on it. You can't miss it, you know, it shouts at you from across the room. People now, I think, can take their own interests and make that part of the cake. I mean, we did a lovely cake earlier this summer for a girl who was a geologist, and it was a pile of rocks, like a rock cairn, with four different types of rock. And when I took it to the venue, the caterers actually weren't sure whether they were cakes or rocks, and everybody was just amazed. And she sent this lovely thank you letter saying that, you know, she was able to do a whole speech around her cake, so it made her whole evening much easier. From the point of view of strange cakes, I've had a wonderful cake that was a large waterfall, because the groom proposed to the bride underneath this waterfall when they were in South America, so that became a very important cake for them. I've done jungle cakes with couples on elephants, we've done lots of scuba diving. I mean, pretty much, you know, anything you want we can do. When you look at a wedding cake, the thing that's important is the look of it, but also the taste of the cake, because what people remember at the end of the day is the taste of the cake as well as how nice it looked. And I think it's so important, if you're offering a homemade cake, that it actually is a cake that I've weighed out the ingredients and lovingly mixed together and put in my oven and cooked. And then it does taste like a homemade cake. As far as choosing a flavour for a wedding cake, you can pretty much have whatever you want. Obviously things like fresh cream can only be put in a cake on the actual day that it's going to be consumed. So if you want a rather more elaborate design that's going to take longer to do, then you need to steer away from the fresh cream, or actually have the cake served with fresh cream rather than it being incorporated with the cake as you see it on the table. Flavour-wise, I'm doing all sorts of things like passion fruit cake, which goes very nicely with the sort of the more eastern elements that are often coming into wedding menus, because you have to remember that the cake's coming at the end of a meal and you want it to complement the whole evening, really. The pink cake over here, again, was designed this time to match the bodice of the bridesmaids' dresses. It's done in a silver, and with all the metallic colours, what you have to do is pipe them the icing in a white or a cream, and then overpaint with the metallic luster to get that sheen and the metallic look. So you wait until the icing's dry, and then you paint, in this case, the silver edible luster on top. And we also, for this, decided to use the little paper roses that you can see here in two different shades, simply because we wanted a lot of little tiny flowers. An alternative would be to stack the cakes one on top of the other and then just maybe have one real fresh rose on the top, which will give you a different look again. I think there's an element of love and a care and attention in every cake you do, and particularly if it's a design that inspires me or I'm thrilled by it, you always go that extra mile and make it that little bit better, that little bit more special, because you really care about it. It's your baby at the end of the day, and you know what you're putting on display is a part of you as much as anything else.